This is Johnny. Wave hello to the folks, Johnny. Like you, he has just received a Bible of his very own. Haven't you, Johnny? He is very excited about his Bible, and he can't wait to read it. But he has a problem. As he tries to read it, he looks confused. What's the matter, Johnny? Oh, it appears that Johnny is confused by all the pages and the strange words. How does Johnny know where to start in enjoying his new Bible? Well, let's help Johnny out, shall we? Let's begin right at the beginning to learn where the Bible came from, shall we? It all begins here, a long time ago, before the words of the Bible were written down. God's people told stories to each other, amazing stories about who God is and how God relates to the world. And then, over time, people began to write these stories down, and they were collected to form the library of books that we now have as the Bible. That's right, the Bible is not really just one book, but a collection of 66 books. Each book is different and has a slightly different way of saying something about God. Some books are like poetry, like the Psalms and the Proverbs. Some books are like letters, written to a person or a group of people. And some books are like history, telling us about things that happened a long time ago. And some books are like biographies, telling us stories about the lives of important people. So you see, Johnny, the Bible is full of lots of different kinds of books. But do you know what? All of the Bible really points to the very same message. That's right. The Bible is all about God's love for you. Yes, you, it's true. The Bible is a love letter from God to you and to everyone. And you know what that means. That means that you are a part of the stories in the Bible. Yes, you. Well, not that, Johnny. When you read the Bible, you discover a lot about God and yourself. How you are made in God's image to be special. How you sometimes make mistakes. How much God helps you when you're afraid. How much you need God. And how important it is to follow God. But most importantly, how much God really, really loves you. It's all in there. Now, how about all those weird words and strange places? Fortunately, there's some help for you in your Bible. It contains some very special tools, like maps, that help you learn about all the places that the Bible talks about. Many Bibles also contain articles that help you understand the people and the concepts that seem strange. But most of all, there's one tool that will help you to figure out what's in the Bible. It's reading it with other people, like your parents, like people at your church, like other kids, just like you. John Wesley, the founder of Methodism, used to call the early Methodists a people of one book. That meant that the Bible brings us together, and we can best understand it when we share it with each other. Sounds pretty exciting, doesn't it? Well, I think it's time for you to dig into your Bible. Have fun!